Hello and welcome to WP Beginner. In this video, we'll walk through how to make your WordPress site completely private. So as we cover this, you might be wondering, well, why would I need to make my blog private? Well, some good features for that would be, say, an intranet site for your company, or even if you just want your own private diary or journal area, and you only want it accessible for yourself and no one else. To get that functionality, we're going to install a plugin called My Private Site. This is what it looks like from the repository. And to do that, we'll just go into the back of our dashboard, head over to the plugins area, add new, and I'm going to search for my private site. This is the one we want, so we'll install now. Finally, let's activate it, and we'll be ready to go into settings to configure. We can either go here for settings or go under settings itself and go to private site for future. You see up here, you automatically get a notification that it's not turned on, so that's okay, we're in here to turn it on. To make it private, we'll just click this and save changes. Right. Once we set that up, you can also allow self-registration. That way anyone can register. And once they register, they'll have to log in before they can actually see the site. Down here, you also can decide where to send them once they log in. By default, it'll just return them to the same URL. If you have a very specific page, you can add that here. If you want to set up a custom login, then you can select this here and add the login location here. And then if you need to have visible exclusions, meaning do you want the site home to be visible for everyone to see, and then they will have to log in to see the rest? Or for instance, is the site visible to everyone? You can click that here. Or will it just be visible to anyone who logs in? And now that we've made the site private, click Save Changes. Once you save all the changes, in order to see how it looks on your site, you'll want to go and log out. Once you log out and you try to access the site, it'll automatically take you to the login screen. This is a good example of why you may want to show, say, the home page for anybody to look at it so they have an idea of what they're doing. Once I log in, I now see everything just fine. Now, if you're just looking to make certain posts private, well, WordPress has a built-in functionality over here under visibility. You see that it's public is by default, and you can either password protect it or make it private over here. And when you make it private, people who have editor or above can see it once they're logged in. And that's a quick overview on how to make your WordPress blog completely private.
If you like this video, click on the like button and go ahead and leave us a comment there. We'd love to hear from you. And subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest videos.